Everyone, this is Toyo from Hokago Card Time, and finally we're back making videos again after 1 year of not doing anything. So as you all know, soon enough it will be time for Premium Collection 2020, and a lot of people have been making noise about this one card called Rain Elemental Zazan. Rain Elemental Zazan is a Cray Elemental Grade 1 that's pretty much been ruining everything in the format. And as members of the Hokago Card Time, this week I want to start showing off some decks that absolutely abuse Zazan and will probably ruin standard format if left unchecked. Now, starting things off with Zazan week, we have Odysseus Zazan. This is an Aqua Force deck using the Ripple Core of Flash Ripple Odysseus and the Grade 1 Ripple Sotirio and the Grade 2 Ripple Pavroth and a whole bunch of Vanillas and Zazan and Tempest Sphere and a whole bunch of broken synergies. So first things off, we have Zazan, the card that pretty much is absolutely busted and everyone says is busted. So what does this little blue thing actually do? Well, first of all, it's a Grade 1. It has an on-play skill on Vanguard Circle or Rear Guard Circle. You can Soul Blast 1. And you can call up to 2 cards without auto, taunt, or act in its ability text. So in other words, you only have to call vanillas. Now what do you do after you call 2 vanillas? Well, Zazan refunds you by drawing 2 cards, and on top of that, it allows you to flip a Storm Elemental Cyclone from your G-Zone face up. What does Storm Elemental Cyclone do? Well, Cyclone gives all of your units without abilities plus 5k during your turn, and this ability stacks, so if you have multiple Zazans, then all of your units will get plus 5, and then plus 10, and then plus 15, and then plus 20, and it's just absolutely out of control. So, how exactly do we abuse Zazan with Aqua Force? And as you might have guessed from the thumbnail, we have our old friend Flash Ripple Odysseus. Odysseus was once banned in around late 2016, I would say, because it broke the format with Grade 2 Gaming. What Odysseus does is act on rear guard once per turn. You can put one of your rear guards to soul, and then you ride a card from your deck, a ripple card from your deck, with the same grade as your current Vanguard. So if you have a Grade 1, you ride the Grade 1 ripple. If you have a Grade 2, you ride the Grade 2 ripple. Simple as that, basically. Now after you ride, you get to call a card from your soul with the same grade as your current Vanguard. So you can start to see why this is a little bit broken with our little blue friend there. Because you can put a Zazan to soul, you use Odysseus to ride another Grade 1, and then you call back the Zazan, soul by something, and then you get to call 2 more, so you have 2 Cyclones up. You can do this on the first turn, which is even more ridiculous, because now you're swinging on turn 1 with 19k columns, with 22k grade 2s, and just absolutely ridiculous numbers that will beat over even 2 defensive triggers, or 3. Now, for the rest of the deck, we have a Tempest Sphere. Tempest Sphere is a new order card. It is once per turn, like all order cards are. What it does is, by discarding it and paying Counterblast 1, you get to flip a card in your G-Zone face-up. After that, you look at the top 7 cards of your deck and find 2 vanillas from among those cards. Now, this card is mostly just a consistency engine, but you can also use it to do some pretty cool stuff. For example, using this G-Guard Galfila, you get to flip it face up using Tempest Sphere, and then by paying Soul Blast 1, you can close it again to countercharge the damage you used for Tempest Sphere. So essentially, you only paid Soul Blast 1 to add 2 cards from your deck to your hand. And these 2 cards can be heals for G-Guards, it can also be a critical trigger for Rogue Shield with Fuel Your Zazan. Now, moving on as to why we chose Aqua Force, other than the previously mentioned Odysseus, you also have access to a really, really, really strong Grade 3 ride in Navalgazer Dragon. Now, this is an old TD card from 2018, so you might be a bit confused as to why it's here and not Glory Maelstrom or Revan or something else that's a bit newer. The reason Navalgazer is here is because, well, when you ride it, you get an XL1 marker, so you can already place another rear guard, which is probably going to be a vanilla, which is getting buffed from Cyclone, so it's going to be swinging for, I don't know, maybe 27, 37. Now, not only that, but when you attack with it, if it's the third battle of that turn or more, you get to pay Counterblast 1 to stand one of your rear guards. Now, this is obviously really good with Cyclone in general, because all of your rear guards are not only huge, but you know, you have 5 attacks on your Great 3 turn, and all of them will be pretty much way too big for your opponent to guard, especially if they're on Great 2. But, well, if they're not on Great 2, then you get to stride. As for Aqua Force, well, we have some really, really strong stride options, shall we say. From last year, we have Torrent of Determination, Valeos Revive. So, Valeos Revive is a Great 4 stride, 15k power. You can stride it like pretty much every other stride. And his skill is when you attack, you play Counterblast 1, and you flip a card in your G-Zone face up. After that, you get to call 2 cards from your hand to rearguard circle for each of your face-up cards in your G-Zone. If you call 3 or more, your opponent's power is locked to 11k. This means they can't increase it through damage triggers, they can't increase it through skills, they pretty much are stuck to 11k for the rest of the turn, and you get to wail on them, basically. how exactly is Torrent of Determination broken? With Zazan, well, as previously mentioned, you get to flip up a lot of cards with Zazan. Like, if you use Cyclone on turn 1, and then... No, sorry, not Cyclone. If you use Odysseus to activate Zazan twice on turn 1, then you already have 2 face-up cards in your G-Zone. Then when you use Valeos' skill, you flip another one so you have 3. So you can call 6 cards to rearguard circle, which is, well, 2 columns and an Axel circle. So you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 7 attacks on your first grade, on your first stride, and they're all huge because of Cyclone. They'll be buffed by like 15k or 20k each. Your columns will be somewhere around 60k, 50k, something like that. And your opponent's Vanguard is stuck at 11k. Defensive triggers won't save them. Defensive G-Guards won't save them. Pretty much they have to just take it or they lose. So obviously, because of the CB cost, sometimes Valeos Revive is not always the correct choice, and that's why we still have our old boy, Lambros. Lambros is a really old card, you might remember him from GBT02. When he attacks, if it's the 4th attack of that turn or more, you get to stand 2 of your rear guards and they get plus 10k. Now usually Lambros isn't used because he's kinda slow. He needs a card in your G-Zone face up before you get to use his skill. And pretty much Zazan just fixes this all by himself. And so you get to use Lambros as your first stride if you don't have a counterblast, and still just absolutely wreck your opponent. Like, you get to stand 2 rear guards, so that's 6 attacks, and they're all huge, and they get plus 10k on top, and yeah, basically Aqua Force is doing Aqua Force things, except now they're really, really big. To fill out the rest of the G-Zone, we have two copies of Alexandros, actually. Alexandros is another GR from GBT13. When he swings, you pay counterblast 1, stand 2 of your rear guards, and they get power plus 5 for each of your face-up cards in your G-Zone. Usually, when you use Alexandros' skill, you're gonna be having 3, 4, maybe sometimes 5 cards in your G-Zone face-up, so they'll get plus 25. It's essentially an even bigger Lambros, just buries your opponent in power. It's an absolutely crazy deck. So, trigger lineup, we're running 12 crits. We also have the new crit from Premium Collection. This is a Strider crit. This is mostly just so you can stride whenever you want to and not be stuck on Great 3 without discarding too many cards. We don't play PGs because PGs don't exist in Zazan format because, well, you know, you want to call your vanillas. It's pretty much aggro, the format. And this is one of the best ways to aggro, I think. Not only is Zazan with Odysseus a massive plus to your card advantage, you also get to turn on 2 Cyclones face up, so your rear guards will be swinging for really, really, really big. This deck is a symptom, I think, of what Zazan is going to do to the format. It turns the format into a very aggro focused format. Like, there is no point in playing slowly when Zazan is forcing these massive columns on you on turn 1, on turn 2, and it's really consistent too, because all of the deck is vanillas, you don't really need any combo pieces, you just hard mull for Zazan, and you can steamroll your opponent. Hey guys, post-editing Toyo here. So, fear-mongering about Zazan aside, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. As you can tell, we're trying out something new with Hokago Card Time. You might have noticed the new VTuber avatar, wink, 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 wink. And also, we're trying out a new editing style. I hope you guys like it, and if you don't like it, tell us why. etc. Comments are always welcome in the comment section. And aside from that, make sure to subscribe, turn on the bell notifications so you don't miss any new uploads. And that will be all from me today. Thank you all. See you next time. Bye bye.